Namaskar. In this video, we'll start with a very important topic. That is how to analyze a Prashna chart. Prashna is a horoscope for the moment. You all must have been aware of. There is a speciality with Prashna. There are 2-3 specialities with Prashna and why we refer to it. Speciality number one, it gives you answer of those things that you cannot see easily from normal system, from normal natal horoscope. For an example, you can ask me a question that, sir, when I will get married, and I can answer that from a natal chart. How will be my natal life? I can answer it from the natal chart. But if you ask, sir, will I get married to this lady? I will not be able to answer it, because in the horoscope I can see the traits of a person, but I cannot see the picture of a person. I cannot see the address of a person. Prashna answers that particular thing for you. So in Prashna, you can really ask a question that, sir, will I get married to my girlfriend? And a Prashna will give you an answer as a yes or a no. Whereas in the natal chart, you cannot do this. In the natal chart, you can only know the nature and the character of the wife. But does the present lady in relationship with you is the one, or there will be someone else with the similar qualities? That is not clarified. That is the first uses when it comes to Prashna. The second thing is also related to the same stuff, that because Prashna is pinpointed, it is easy. For an example, when you go in a natal chart, when you have to find when this person will get a job, you have to go through a whole lot of techniques. You have to analyze the 10th house, you have to analyze the 10th lot, then you have to go to Dasha, you have to find the appropriate suitable Dasha. It is a time-taking process. Whereas the Prashna chart can be directly pointed to when will I get a job. The whole chart will only indicate the possibility of the job, and the complete of the Dasha will only work with regard to job. So in Prashna chart, all the factors are related to that matter for which the question is asked. Whereas in a natal chart, all things, all the planets, all the influences deal with respective matters. So that is the second thing. The third important thing is the non-availability of birth times. Generally, people are not very sure of their birth time. Elders even don't know their birth year, birth month. They are not sure about it. In that scenario, Prashna helps you a lot. Generally, someone who don't have their birth details or doesn't know their accurate birth details, you will not be able to predict for them, because you will have a doubt on their chart. In that particular scenario, you can use a Prashna and can quickly give them an answer. The Prashna system, also known as horary astrology, is so exhaustive that if you don't know about your whereabouts, if you don't know about your details, you can ask a question as, what are my birth details? Or I want to know about my birth time. And Prashna is so exhaustive and Prashna is so extensive that just based on a horary horoscope, just based on the horoscope of that moment, doing some calculations, you can find the actual natal chart of a person. And this is known as Nastjatak or lost horoscopy. And my experience with this particular branch have been very good. Till date, I have done at least 15, 16 Nastjatakas, 15, 16 lost horoscopes for people, where people have asked me questions about their birth details. I made a Prashna, did some calculations, made a chart, gave predictions on that chart. And out of those 16 people, one person have already died. So I have, from his 80th year of age up to the 90th year of age until he died, for all the, I made his Nastjatak horoscope. I reconstructed his horoscope at the 85th year of age gave 4 or 5 predictions that came true, and the person died in 1990 years of age.
Wow, sir, 1616 or 6060?
6060. So that is some. 16, 1616. This is a branch, and I wanted to talk about this particular thing because I think that many astrologers are not aware of that there is something as such. Yeah, there is something known as Nashta Jatak, and there are few books on it. But mind my words that it is something that cannot be learned from books. This is something that comes through experiences only. However, Nashta Jatak sometime else, at some other point of time. Today, I want to quickly talk about how to read a Prashna chart. I am very sure that with my explanation of this particular thing that I have done up to this extent, you have clearly understood the importance of a Prashna chart. Without going into any technicalities, without doing much hard work, you can just make a horoscope for that moment and start predicting things. It's quite amazing. Time saving. So, regarding the quick analysis of Prashna, today I will want to share 5 techniques with you. Technique number 1. Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Sagittarius, Capricorn are night strong signs. Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Aquarius, and Pisces are a day strong sign. When you ask a question in daytime, in a day strong sign as an ascendant, the matter of the Prashna is very strong. Whereas, if you ask a question in a daytime and the ascendant is a night strong sign, then the matter of the Prashna is not very strong. The same thing goes for night also. If a Prashna is asked in night and the ascendant is night strong, then the thing of object of the Prashna is strong. Whereas if the Prashna is asked in the night time and the ascendant is day strong, then the matter of the Prashna is not strong. What do I mean by that? Suppose someone asks you that, sir, will I get married to this lady? At night time, if it is a night ascendant, then the person is very strongly devoted to getting married to that lady. Whereas if it is a day strong ascendant, then the person is not very strongly devoted to getting married to that lady. He may be just asking a casual question to you. Right? And the strength of the ascendant, night strong sign in the night Prashna, day strong sign in the day Prashna, will also decide the result being benefic or the result being malefic. Right? So that is the technique 1. That you find the time when the Prashna is being asked and the nature of the sign, whether it is day strong or night strong. If the question is asked at the daytime in a day strong Lagna, that means the ascendant is strong, which means that the matter of the Prashna have a very strong say in the life of the person, and the answer is 50% positive. Just because it is a day strong ascendant. Going to another part of it, there is 2 types of signs. Shirshodayi, Prishthodayi. Gemini, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio, Aquarius. And for that matter, Pisces also. is Sirsodei head rising. Other signs: Aries, Taurus, Cancer, Sagittarius, Capricorn are Trishthodei, which means head rising. Any question asked in a Sirsodei Lagna increases. Any question asked in a Trishthodei Lagna decreases. In this particular matter, you have to pay a lot of attention on the type of question it is. For an example, if the person is asking, sir, will the disease increase? If it is a Sirsodei Lagna, you have to say, yes, it will increase. If it is a Trishthodei Lagna, you have to say, no, it will not increase. But if someone asks the question, sir, will I benefit health? Will I, you know, like, will I be able to come out of the disease? Will I be able to recover? Then, because now the question is focused on recovery and not on disease, the Sirsodei Lagna will tell you that yes, the recovery will increase. Whereas the Trishthodei Lagna will tell you that no, the recovery will not increase. Right? So that is the second technique. And to use the second technique, you have to put more emphasis on how the question is being asked. The person is asking of the same thing, but he can ask, sir, the disease will increase. Or he can ask, sir, will I recover early? Will I recover quickly? So you have to pay attention to the thing that is being asked. Second technique. Going further, very quickly, the third thing to analyze the prashna, quickly analyze the prashna, is to analyze about the particular house lord. You have to first find to which house the question is connected to. And mind my words, these are just the basics. Basics works 80% of the time. 20% of the time cannot be guaranteed. For 20% guarantee, you should use the advanced principle of Prashna analysis that I am going to teach in the Art of Prashna. Coming back to my topic, the house lord is very important. When someone asks you a question that, sir, will I get married? In that case, if the seventh lord is in 6th, 8th, or 12th house, you know that the result looks negative. Then you have to tell the person that right now the time is not good. You may not get married. Right. Whereas, if in the same chart, the seventh lord is in 1st, 4th, 7th, or 10th house known as Kendras, or 1st, 5th, or 9th house known as Trikonas, or in the 11th house of Gain, in that scenario, you should say them that definitely you will get married. So third way, the third quick thing is to see the house lord and check in which house that house lord is placed. If it is placed in a favorable house, favorable results are related to that prashna is going to come. If the house lord is in an unfavorable house, then unfavorable or bad results related to prashna is going to come. The fourth technique that I will want to discuss is, what is prashna? That is something that you have to pay attention to. What is prashna? Prashna works with the philosophy that the time when the thought arises in your mind, that time also have an answer for it. That is the philosophy. I will repeat that. The time when the question comes in your mind, that same time have the answer of the question as well. So the third quick technique, and it is a very, very important technique. The third quick technique is to find influences on the ascendant. Ascendant indicates the quality of the time for that moment. For an example, right now, it is Capricorn ascendant. So what is the quality of time right now? The quality of time right now is Capricorn. And in Capricorn sign, there is Saturn right now. So how is the quality of sign? How is the quality of time right now? The quality of time is Capricorn plus Saturn. So the time have a delaying factor. The time have a denial factor. The time have a laziness factor. The time have some hardworking factors. And depending on what type of prashna is being asked, whether it is a daytime or a nighttime, the time have the seed of disease into it. The time have the seed of misfortune into it. That is all because of Saturn. Same thing with Capricorn. So prashna is the analysis of the time. And the most important thing, the most important element of a panchang, the most important element of a time is the lagna or the ascendant that is rising at that particular moment. In that scenario, you know about the benefic planets and the malefic planets, Jupiter, Moon, Mercury, Venus. These four planets are benefic. Sun, Mars, Saturn, Rahu, Ketu. These five planets are malefic. Along with this, all the odd signs, Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, and Aquarius are considered malefic. Whereas all the female signs, Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces are considered benefic. This malefic or benefic decides how is the experience. The experience of Aries, Gemini, Leo, Libra, Sagittarius, and Aquarius, the experience is troublesome. Whereas for Taurus, Cancer, Virgo, Scorpio, Capricorn, and Pisces, the experience is pleasant. You enjoy the experience. Whereas other thing is the sign lauded by Jupiter, Pisces, and Sagittarius, the sign lauded by Moon, Cancer, the sign lauded by Mercury, Gemini, and Virgo, and the sign lauded by Venus, Taurus, and Libra are benefic. Whereas the sign lauded by Sun, Leo. Whereas the sign lauded by Mars, Aries, and Scorpio. Whereas the sign lauded by Saturn, Capricorn, and Aquarius are malefic. This decides how is the end result. Benefic, good end result. Malefic, bad end result. So whenever you go to analyze a prashna chart, my fourth technique that I will want to talk is to check the influences on the ascendant. Let me give you an example. Suppose someone asks you a question. Take this chart. This is for the moment. Suppose this person asks me a question that, sir, I want to get money from this person. I want to get benefited in monetary terms from this particular person. Will I be able to get the benefit? Because the second lord is in the ascendant, you should say that yes. If this is a night strong sign, Saturn is in the ascendant, you will say that yes, you will be able to get monetary benefit from that person. But that is a malefic planet in a female sign and the malefic Rashi. And the result will be pleasant also. You ask the person for money and the person will give you money. But the end result will be bad. The end result will be that your asking of money will distort your relationship with that person. And why it will be bad? Because after returning you your money, that person will grow well in life. And after some time, you will be on the situation to ask for his help. And that time, he will refuse. Just a possibility. Getting my point. This is something subtle and this is something that no one in astrology is going to teach you. Suppose in this same chart, if the seventh Lord Moon was in the seventh house. Suppose the same chart. In this same chart, the seventh Lord Moon is in the seventh house. What will you say? If the person asks that, sir, will I get married to this lady if moon is in the seventh house? Because of the seventh Lord in the seventh house and the sign being night strong, you will say that, yes, you will get married to this lady. But how will be that marriage? Will you be happy out of that marriage or no? The answer is pretty simple. The ascendant is a malefic sign with Saturn into it. That is a female sign. You will get married easily. There will be not much part on getting married. But after marriage, sadness, grief, misery, disease, etc. will come. And despite the Prashna showing the chances, despite the Prashna indicating the chances of getting married, the end result of the marriage, the result after you achieve the thing, the result after the Prashna fructifies will not be good. The last very important thing that I will want to discuss is whenever you see a Prashna chart, always pay a very close attention to the fourth house. This is something that I have learned from a very experienced person who was, when I met him, he was quite old. That was, fourth house indicates happiness. And what do you want in life? Except than happiness, right? So whenever there is a question in front of you, whenever there is a prashna, always check the fourth house. And as per the fourth house, you decide that whether it is even worthy enough to work for this prashna or not. For an example, if the fourth house is afflicted, the question is related to joining a job, and the prashna answers you that yes, you will get the job and you will also be very happy in job. Right? For an example, suppose take this particular chart only. Here the 10th Lord is in the 5th house. Suppose this person is asking that, sir, I want to get a promotion and my boss told me that, okay, I will promote you and I will also transfer you to Pune. Sir, should I get it? The 10th Lord is in the 5th house. 5th house indicates the gain of position. So the Prashna is positive. Prashna indicates that the person will get promoted, but the 4th house is having Sun, a malefic into it. That is also Digbalheen. That is also devoid of directional strength. And in Navamsha, this Sun is debilitated. That means that despite the Prashna indicating that you will achieve what you are wishing for, but still it will not make you happy. the realization of the result, getting what you wanted, will not make you happy because the fourth house is in a bad condition. Thus, it is advised for such a person to not run behind the promotion, but to have satisfaction in whatever he have and ask the prashna after some time. And that some time is at least after 40 days, not before 40 days, right? These are a few of the quick techniques to analyze prashna quickly. And in the starting of the video itself, I have told you about the prashna system of astrology and how fantastic, fabulous, and mind-blowing it is. Just to inform you, from the 14th of this month, from the 14th of May, I'm going to do a 4-month course on Prashna by the name of Art of Prashna, where I will teach you the most essential principles to analyze a Prashna chart from Prashna Marg and Krishniyam. That is a 4-month course where we will have classes once a week, night time at 9 p.m. We will have classes. One class a week. It is a 4-month course priced at 4,500 rupees per month. Right? In that course, we will learn all the essential and fundamental principles of a Prashna chart analysis. If you want to progress in astrology, if you want to practice as an astrologer, if you want to learn astrology, or if you want to get the power of making accurate predictions and being able to guide people or yourself, learning Prashna is very important, and there is nothing better than this particular course that I'm doing. So if you're serious about learning Prashna, if you're serious about astrology, want to learn it from authentic source, please join.
And there is one more thing, sir. I mean, even if somebody is there and they are not getting any clients or they are not doing astrology professionally, they can still learn these Prashna techniques for their own sake so that they can look into their own issues. That is very important.
Learning Prashna is even very important for those who never want to become an astrologer, because Prashna helps you in day-to-day decisions. And every person have to take a day-to-day decision. Should you buy a car today? Your old friend have called you up, or someone whom you had a fight with some years ago, they try to contact you again. Should you be in contact with them again? Should you purchase a vehicle? Should you invest in the property? Should you buy a mobile today? Will your friend asks money from you? What is his intention? These are all the basic questions that Prashna answers for you. So even if you don't want to become an astrologer, that's not an issue. But even for common person, if you want to use the power of astrology for betterment in your life, you should learn Prashna. That's for very, very sure. Thank you for reminding it, Nathan. Thank you for watching the video. Namaskar.